What the hell?
I knocked. You didn't answer.
You gotta quit doing this.
Doing what?
Sneaking around. You're stopping by. You're breaking and entering.
I came here for the view.
So, Justin, with Tracker and Coulter Shaw, do you feel like lightning has kind of struck twice for you?
Yeah, in a way. In a way, I do. Not to take anything away from the people that I work with, you know, starting with Dan Fogelman, who gave me the opportunity to even, you know, be in that on that show, that wonderful show. Not to take anything away from Ken Olin, who worked his tail off to executive produce this show with me and build this thing from the ground up. Not take anything away from Jeffrey Deaver, who wrote the book, The Never Game, or the rest of my cast or the crew, or the hard work that I put in. But yeah, you know, there are a lot of people in this business that work really, really hard and don't sniff this kind of opportunity that leads into this kind of success. So I'm very, very lucky. I understand that. We do work really, really hard, though. And I think, you know, between Dan Fogelman and his taste and his sensibilities with This Is Us, and then Ken Olin and his taste and, you know, my work ethic, hopefully, and the talent of the cast and the crew and everything, we stand a good chance, I think, to have a successful show. When you have that combination of people working together, trying to achieve a common goal, I think your chances of success go way, way up. Than if you were to just have a great idea, or that you were like, you had great people, but not a great idea. Or, I mean, you have to have everything together. And we've done that with this show. So, then again, like you said, you never know. I've seen really great shows with really great acting, before that go 4 or 5 episodes and they're canceled for some reason. They never find an audience. So the fact that we found an audience, it feels good. It's a relief, you know, when you put in all that effort and people are actually enjoying what you're doing.
So Justin, what was it about Coulter Shaw and Tracker and this universe that Jeffrey Deaver created in the books that kind of hooked you and made you say, this is the one, this is the project I want to do next?
It was the people that I was, you know, having an opportunity to work with. It was the studio, the network, Ken, it was the character that Jeffrey created. The idea that this guy roams into a town and uses, I love the backstory, the family backstory, and the fact that sort of shaped the man that he is. And he could have gone either way. You know, a lot of times when people have those, those experiences in their childhood, it shapes them, but in a different way, right? In a way that you don't really want to be. I mean, he could have been a weirdo in prison. Like, you never know, right? I mean, these things happen to people and it goes one way or the other. But I love the fact that he took all of that trauma, I guess, from his childhood and is now using it to do good. I just think that's so cool. I love how grounded the character is as well. I just love that he's not a superhero. He's a man. He could get killed. He's putting himself at risk. And I haven't really seen a character like that is like on a procedural, really. You know, it's not necessarily a team show. We don't really have a team show. We have a single lead show, and he uses other people. He has other people in his life that he uses to get stuff that he needs, right? But it's not this big team show, which is kind of interesting. I just like that as well. And then it's a departure from what I had just done. I think the opportunity of my life was This Is Us. I still cherish every moment of that show. And I did when I was on it. I understood what it was when I was on it. I couldn't believe it. I was like, I can't believe I'm part of this fantastic thing. But to be able to do something kind of immediately after, I took a little bit of a break. I didn't take a break, but there was a strike and there was all that stuff. But to do a character immediately after that is so different is also kind of an actor's dream, I think, or at least my dream. So I just wanted to dive into something different. And this allowed me to do that. And, you know, Ken always says instead of carrying babies, he's carrying a gun, which is kind of the truth. You know, it is very different. But at the same time, he does lead. He does lead with his heart and all that kind of stuff. So there is that element to it where he's just a really good guy who's easy to root for, I think.
Are you a big outdoors kind of guy? And do you like the idea of hooking up a Airstream and just vanishing off into the wilderness somewhere?
I am now. I have no choice. I work these like 16, 17 hour day, whatever it is. I'm outside all the time. So it's like, you know, you better like it, bud. It's your whole life, you know?
So Jensen Ackles is going to be playing your brother. What can you tell us about how's that dynamic going to change when we get to meet Russell?
It's intense. You know, he comes into Coulter's life. He's been bothering, pestering him kind of the whole year, and you're kind of wondering why. And we tell that story in the, coming up in a couple of episodes where, you know, you start to understand as an audience member why the time had to be now that he came into Coulter's life and what he needs from him and what the expectations are and all of that kind of stuff. So we get into that pretty early on in the episode, and it's pretty deep. And then there's another set of circumstances that happens that put these two estranged brothers on a journey to try to solve something, you know, they have a common goal in mind. And throughout all of that, a bunch of the backstory is told, in a natural way, in a way that it would be. And we have a lot of action. We have some, you know, buddy action, you know, buddy comedy action stuff that sort of just kind of happens naturally. It wasn't necessarily in the script. It just sort of physical stuff that happened between me and Jensen. I've known him for so long. And we've been trying to work together for a long time, or, you know, I mean, wanting to work together for a long time. We haven't been actively pursuing it, but this was just a great opportunity. You know, he texts me, you know, one day he was like, please get off my television. I'm trying to watch a football game. And, because of all the promotions that, you know, that we're doing for Tracker. And I just wrote back, oh, thanks. He goes, hey, show's great. Congratulations. I said, you want to play my brother? Just kind of like mentioning it, you know, and he's like, when and where? And that's how these things happen. So we're lucky to have him. He was great. He was really, really great. Great to the crew. Great. I mean, he's just a pro. He's such a talented actor, and just nailed it. Just came in and nailed it. And we worked him like crazy. Worked him every day. And he was there to work. But the episode is terrific. I've seen the episode. I've seen what I think is the final cut, and it's terrific. It's one of our best.
What was it like working with your wife? She guest starred on an episode earlier this season.
Yeah, she's going to be back. She's going to be back by popular demand. We came on. We had this really great opportunity to work together. And again, a natural way, the writers wrote this really great, sort of like Mr. and Mrs. Smith, James Bond kind of really, really cool episode for her, where she got to come in and be a badass that she is. She that's what she is. That's what she does. And she crushed it. And I can't tell you, I mean, how many times people came up to me and they say, man, I really love your show. Your show's just great. And episode 6 was Sofia, my favorite. And then they just start talking about her. And I'm like, I feel like I'm on her show, which makes me so happy, you know, because I always have said to people, you know, one of the hardest jobs in Hollywood is a guest star. You come in, you're supposed to crush it. You get one or two takes. You don't really have a lot of creative input. And you don't, you know, you don't know anybody. It's like being traded to another team in the middle of the season, or shifting high schools in the middle of the year when everybody has their friends and you're just like standing there. And so one of the things that I try to do on our show is make sure that that's not what our guest stars are. Our guest stars are a huge, huge part of our show. It's the people that I work with the most are the guest stars. So try to make them feel at home and have creative input and all of that kind of stuff. And of course, Sophia's story is a little different. I mean, she knew everyone, but she just came in and absolutely crushed it. And now we have this really beautiful character that can come in that has a past with Coulter that can, you know, you can drudge up all of this stuff from their past and try to figure all that out. We've built this. I mean, we have these such dynamic characters. Sophia's character, Billy. We have Jensen's character, Russ. Dory, who's coming in, played by Melissa Roxburgh, who's Coulter's sister, is coming in next week. That's a whole thing that's happening. Jennifer Morrison coming on in the finale, who has a past with Coulter as well. Not a romantic past, but a really cool episode with her coming up. We just have a lot of people that came in and helped us out in a really good way, and we're lucky. I look at the cast now and I'm like, wow, we got a bunch of TV stars on our show. It's incredible. You know, what a lucky guy. I don't know how this happened, but we're producing good television, so life is good.
So you're like over 20 years into this acting journey. I don't know your story. You came on This Is Us, and just that was the first time I really knew about you. Obviously, I'd seen you on Smallville as well. But so tell me, how does that story work for you? Did you just show up in Hollywood with a dream? Did you have a plan? Did you have a role? How did it all work for you? And I don't even know if you can tell me that story.
Yeah, I left after college and moved to LA, where at the time it was like where all the work was. I don't know if that's the case anymore. But I had a plan to, like, after school, just to go out there and try to figure it out. I had an experience in college with an acting class or a performance class. And I had never really considered it as a profession. I know I always enjoyed, like, entertaining people and stuff, but I never considered it as, like, something you could do, make a living at. And for whatever reason. And I just fell in love with it. I just fell in love with it and got the, you know, the acting bug that people talk about. And I thought, well, I don't have anything to lose right now. I have no responsibilities, really. And I don't want to be, you know, the age that I am now and regretting things, because there's no way in hell right now I'd be able to do that. I have too much responsibility and stuff, but I just went out there and ended up figuring out very quickly that I didn't know what the hell I was doing. And so I found an acting class, this class in Santa Monica, Joanne Barron, D.W. Brown Acting Studio in Santa Monica. And it's a pretty intense class. They're pretty serious about their stuff. And I enrolled there and I just studied, and then ended up working shortly after. And I've been lucky. I've been working ever since, pretty much. So it's been good. It's been a lot of work, but, you know, it flies by. When you're doing something that you love, it flies by. Like you said, I've been doing this 20 plus years. I'm like, geez, that's unbelievable. Cause I'm only 27. And so it's like, it's hard to imagine.
So you didn't have a plan B if it didn't work?
No. No, but not to say that, I would be, if it didn't work, I wouldn't be talking to you right now. I would be doing something else. I wouldn't be crying in the corner. I would be doing something else, hopefully meaningful. My mother is a lifelong teacher, and she always says a lifelong learner. And I could see myself doing something like that, like teaching kids or trying to teach them, trying to better other people. I could see myself doing something like that. You know, I always wanted to sort of, and I still kind of fantasize about opening a theater. You know what I mean? And so having like free acting classes there somehow, or figuring that out and just sort of helping other people.
Still lots of time for that. Yeah. Okay, Tracker season 2 got the early renewal. So what are we in store for when it comes back this fall?
Well, we built up a lot of the backstory and a lot of the questions that we haven't answered yet in season 1. In these next 3 episodes, we answer all of those questions, which then kind of fuel a whole nother set of questions, to be honest with you. And you go, wait a minute. So if that's the case, then, oh, this must be what was going on here. Well, what are we going to do? And then that's the season 2, right? So it's a whole nother set of questions. They've done a really good job of kind of wrapping up the season 1 without doing it like a pretty little bow where it's like, oh, everything's, because it's not. It's just like, but all of those questions that you had get answered. But that's what leads to the explosion, which will be season 2.
All right. Before I let you go, This Is Us had probably one of the greatest series finales. Justin, what did you think of the ending?
Those are hard to nail. And I thought so too. I thought Dan and the writers did a pretty fantastic job with all of that. And that's a tough one too, because it's multi-generational and there's so many things that went on, and the show went on for so long and people care so much about all of those characters. You owe it to the audience to tell the story of all those characters. And I thought they did, you know, an amazing job. What looks to be impossible, they somehow figured out.
You're doing that I got a question thing you do. So go ahead, ask your little question. I won't bite.
Not a question, just, you know, more of an observation.
Proceed.
Well, I was just, you know, observing that for such a busy lawyer, you show out at the office a lot.
Well, the office is kind of boring, and this is not so much.
So you're using me to play hooky from work?
This is work. It's called field work.
Mm.